Hey folks, checking in with the first episode of, I don't know quite what I'm going to call it yet, but it's kind of like a skiing style podcast where, well, essentially a backstory. So I have decided to take a bit of a gap year because I never did throughout my schooling, and I've put in like 62 odd days so far this season, and it is currently March 27th. And I figure since I ski like a madman more often than not, anyways, maybe this would be a cool way to kind of integrate mountain life and take the concept of the Rogan podcast style of entertainment, meet people, just sort of put something out there, gain a little ad revenue, maybe a little residual income for doing something that I'm going to do all the time anyways. So this is sort of my intro to the idea, and I don't know why I haven't thought about it before. But we live in the most beautiful part of the world. I'll do a little intro here. This episode will be a little bit just kind of casual, not a lot going on. I'll ski a lap. It's like 3 o'clock-ish now. I'm doing some afternoon golden hour laps, my favorite time of day. And I'm gonna maybe hit around on Symphony, and then maybe I'll do a little cruise or something and some slush, just slurve around a little bit, see what's happening in the village. And we'll see how that goes. And I'll maybe make these about half an hour to an hour long and maybe do them once a week or so. We'll see how it kind of continues on. It's also a good way to reconnect with all my old friends from McNair, from Richmond, from UBC, from Jiu-Jitsu, from all my walks of life that I've kind of put on the back burner. I had a bit of criminal harassment happen in my life. I'm not going to talk too much about it on the podcast or right now. And I kind of withdrew from a lot of my social circles. Now I'm working for myself, I'm self-employed, and just doing things like this, living every day lightly and enjoying my life. And I really hope that everybody gets the same enjoyment out of being outside in the Pacific Northwest that I do. So subscribe, and we'll see how this goes. Let's do some skiing, folks. Cheers.
Intoxicating your kiss, intoxicating your lips. Nobody does it like this. I find it hard to resist. Oh, feeling out of control, beautifully so. What's coming over me? It's a total eclipse of rationality. I don't usually say this. I don't usually play this game. Yeah, I know I'm not faded, but it kinda feels that. I don't usually say this, but I think I should let you know. But baby, baby, I don't wanna go. How could I go home when I feel like I belong? In your arms is like champagne, feel it pouring in my veins. Yeah, I got myself too drunk on you to drive. So I'm crashing here.
Yeah, baby. Fucking A. March 27th. It's a good day to be alive, folks. Hey dude, you wanna hook me up? Yeah, buddy, I'd get on that. Can I have a rip? Can I have a rip? Nah, probably get sued. Oh well. Maybe I'll buy a sled someday.
Tornado warning, today's like the morning after. Your world is torn in half, you're waking its wake to start the morning process. And rebuilding, you're still a work in progress. Today's a whole new chapter, it's like an enormous ass. Thunderstorm has passed you, your weather didn't poke its eye out with the thorn bush that you used to smell the roses. Stop to inhale, can't even tell your noses. Stuff so focused on the bright side, then you floor the gas pedal and hit the corner faster. More assertive, never looking back, may hit the curb, but every day's a new learning curve as you steer through life. Sometimes you might not want to swerve, but you have to avert a disaster. Lucky no permanent damage, cause they hurt you so bad. It's like they murdered your ass and threw dirt on your casket. But you returned from the ashes, and that hurt that you have, you just converted to gasoline. And while you're burning the past, standing at inferno and chained. It's like, it happens all the time. They take your heart and steal your life. And it's as though you feel you've died, cause you've been killed inside. But yet you're still alive, which means you will survive. Although today you may weep cause you're weakened, and everything seems so bleak and hopeless. The light that you're seeking, it begins to seep in. That's the only thing keeping you from leaping off the mother freaking deep in. And I'm pulling for you to push through this feeling, and with a little time that should do the healing. And by tomorrow you may even feel so good that you're willing to forgive them. Even after all this shit you've been put through, this feeling of resilience is building. And the flames are burning quick as fire, went through this building, you're sealed in. But your fireproof flame retard on you withstood it. And as you climb up to the roof, you're just chilling. You look down cause you're so over them. You can put the heel of your foot through the ceiling.
As time passes, things change every day, but wounds heal, the scars they remain the same. But tomorrow, today's going down in flames. Throw the matches at the past up.
So feel the fire beneath your feet as you barely even perspire from the heat. Exhale deep and breathe a sigh of relief as you say goodbye to the grief. It's like watching the walls melt in your prison cell, but you've extinguished this living hell. Still a little piece of you dies as you scream.
Shattered, waking up, and wash off
that warm a good thing about Whistler too. I'm not much of a club guy, but Whistler Village. Yeehaw. Having a good day? Yeah, buddy. What a great day. What a glorious day. It's okay, I'll blur out your face. Bumping at Longhorns. Spring break. Downtown Whist.
Conditions are just right.
Conditions are perfect.
Conditions are perfect.
Hey folks, so another run up the Whistler Gondola. That was a sick lap.
Yeah, I got on right before 4 o'clock. I love doing this because look at this day, man. Like, you get these just beautiful days and no one's on the hill and you can just shred to your heart's content. And you get a couple hours in. My logic is a few people go to the gym a few hours, so you can definitely ski for a couple hours too. And yeah, I'm more of a black home guy myself in terms of where I ski predominantly, but Whistler I do enjoy, especially on a heavy, heavy dump. On a bluebird day, it's hard to beat these bulls up here. It's just, this place is phenomenal. And I always love going up that peak chair. The thing I like about Whistler Blackcomb is you have your spots. So you have your spots, you love to ski, and it's all about getting to those spots before everybody else does, and using the right skis for the given day. I ski 4 different skis. These are my Scratch BC WRS. They're a daily driver. I love them. They're full camber. They have nice pop to them. They're flexy, but not too flexy. They're stiff enough torsionally to hold an edge, yet they flex enough in the tip and tail to keep them nice and fun. Oh, Gandhi, stop. I'm not on the black home breakdown gondola. What's going on here? Anyways, more time to talk to you folks. It is like 4:05. Get a nice lap down. I see people over there cruising on Emmy. Looks pretty nice. But we'll see what we do. Maybe take a run through the park even. These are good for anything. My DPS Whaler 112 RPCs. Anytime over 20 centimeters, those bad boys come out. Just love them. Totally the feeling of being alive. Love those skis. And then I got a pair of Line Afterbangs, which are made like a skateboard. They're skate deck constructions, so they're like veneers of wood stacked on top of each other. And what they're good for is just slamming against rails and boxes and features and taking abuse and not falling apart. And they're poppy, flexy, they have a carbon ollie band throughout them, which allows them to be poppy. And so they ollie really nicely. They're a good ski. I only skied them like half a dozen times. And then I took the bindings off the jibs to put on these because I broke my other bindings. So I got a little project coming on with those skis. The graphics are by Jimbo. He's like a sort of pinup style tattoo artist, real talented guy, but I just don't dig it on my skis. It's like some dude with his eyes falling out, puking up razor blades and like a bunch of other crazy shit. And I just want it off my ski. So I started chipping it off with a pocket knife. I'm going to belt sand it. I'm going to do a nice stain job with some Varathane on the ski. It's going to look real good. It's going to look like a fine coffee table. And then I'm going to use those skis for summer skiing on Blackcomb Glacier, because for those who aren't local, Seventh Heaven, one of my favorite places to ski of all time, behind it is the Blackcomb Glacier. Well, I might as well just use this. Look at this. Damn, scan enough spa. Anyways, the glacier is great because it's open in the wintertime or summertime, so you can ski all year long. Whistler proper is open until May-ish, late May, and then Blackcomb Glacier opens up later in the summer, so it's like going to the beach and skiing. I would actually like to work there this year. Anybody who's in lift ops, give me a shout out if you can, because I'd like to pull T-bars this summer. It's my first season full-time in Blackcomb, Whistler Blackcomb. Second favorite place of all time to ski. Now, I'm sorry, folks. It is my home hill, and I do love it here, hands down. Close second to Revy. I've been there only a few times, but it's never disappointed. It's like Narnia. You just disappear in glades. You think you've gone out of bounds. All of a sudden, you pop out on a cat track, and you're just like trying to, you know, get the chub in your pants to calm down, because it was phenomenal. Just phenomenal. And this year, with the Epic Pass and the RCR resorts, it'd be really cool to try Kicking Horse, and I might still try to get out there for a couple days this season, so stay tuned for that. Aside from that, 60 plus days here in Whistler, a handful of awesome pow days, maybe half a dozen to a dozen real nice powder days this season. Slow start in November, but fucking we got hammered by like 3 feet of snow just in a couple like weeks, and it was just great ever since. So yeah, here we are. Life is good. So what I'll probably do with this podcast is, like, every once in a while on a lift, I'll pop it on. If somebody recognizes the ski suit guy, talk to me. We can have a little chat on here. I'll post it up. I'll probably run these, like, once a week, like I said, and then I'll edit them, put some tunes in that I like, try to find something that's not going to get me pulled off YouTube. Maybe talk to the artist beforehand or whatever. But anyways, some tunes that I like to ski to, so you can feel kind of like you're in my mind while I'm skiing. I might do a few voiceovers too, a few Alan Watts style conversation pieces, things I like to talk about, things that help me get through my day in my life.
And while I'm skiing, I think about those things. So I might even just do some voiceovers from time to time, and it'd be great. So I am approaching the roundhouse, so I'm going to over and out for now. Ooh, look at this. This is also the great part about evening skiing, or afternoon skiing rather, is that the groomers come out, and then you follow those bad boys and you can have a good old time. I realize I'm kind of talking like Bob Ross a little bit. I've been watching a lot of Bob Ross lately. I'm a huge fan. They're like a 20-minute little bite-sized piece of something.
I believe, every day's a good day when you paint. I believe, it'll bring a lot of good thoughts to your heart. I believe, every day's a good day when you paint. I believe, it'll bring a lot of good thoughts to your heart. Let's build a happy little cloud. Let's build some happy little trees. There are no limits here. You start out by believing here. You can almost paint with anything. All you have to do is practice. There are no limits here. You start out by believing here. This is your world. You're the creator. Find freedom on this canvas. Believe that you can do it, cause you can do it, you can do it. Give it a little touch, give it a little push. Make love to the canvas, give it a little touch, give it a little push, 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 caress it. Very gentle, very gentle, very gentle. Grab it, lift it, fluff it. You can go on and on and on. Back and forth and forth. Layer after layer after layer. Let's build a happy little cloud. Let's build some happy little trees. There are no limits here. You start out by believing here. This is your world. You're the creator. Find freedom on this canvas. Believe that you can do it. Cause you can do it. You can do it. Relax. Let it flow. Think like water. Relax. Let it flow. You can go on and on and on. We don't make mistakes. We just have happy accidents. You can do anything that you want to do. Total power. Sing along, have a good time. This is your world. You're the creator. Find freedom on this canvas. Believe that you can do it. Cause you can do it. Cause you can do it. Cause you can do it. I believe, every day's a good day when you paint. I believe, it will bring a lot of good thoughts to your heart. I believe, every day's a good day when you paint. I believe, it'll bring a lot of good thoughts to your heart.
You just, I love Bob Ross, I'm a huge fan. Anyways, the groomers go by, leave a nice corduroy, and that guy's gonna get it, yeah. I've got this a lot of times where I've been the one to put that first line on it, but today is not my day, unfortunately, but it's still a great day. So, without further ado, I will ski another lap. We'll have some fun, and I'll get to editing this, and we'll see where this goes. So, over and out, everyone. Cheers.
Tell me I'm the only one that did it all.
Someone told me long ago, well, there's a mountain before the storm. I know it's been coming. My bus, 31 to Alpine by Nestor. Doesn't get much better than that. Are you having a good day, sir? Did you have a fun day skiing today? You have a fun day?
Yeah.
Yeah, good man. It's a glorious day. Over and out. Folks, so I'm checking in today here, the day after yesterday, which is now the 28th of March, and I'm a little tired today, to be honest, because I went out last night. Golden Features was the artist's name, excellent Australian DJ, house DJ. Now I've learned that he actually tours all over the place. He was in California and I think somewhere else in the States recently, and then he came up here to Max Fish. It was great. I went, it sold out. I heard about it, so I went the night before. They were selling some door tickets. I had a fucking grand old time. And so the bouncer was a nice fella, and I said, well,
is tomorrow sold out? He says, yes, but if you come late, you might still get in, kind of like tonight. So I went, and it was a great old time. So I'm a little tired, though, because basically I had three or four of these, my little, like, late-night aperitifs here, and then went and hit it, and boogied pretty good. It was fun. Man, really good tracks. And but anyways, today what we are doing is... Well, I'm just doing a final recap after the last lap that I skied yesterday. That was a lot of fun, slarving around in the slush, and that groomer actually did get some of the runs for the corduroy from him, so it worked out well. That's another thing. I was talking a bit about pulling T-bars, lift-offs for the summer. That's cool. Another thing I'd really like on my bucket list is slope grooming, because I actually worked for 7-8-odd seasons running heavy equipment, grass tractor, Kubota tractors, John Deere's. And I just love doing honest, straight, easy work, where I say easy in a sense that nothing bad is going to happen. It doesn't involve you using your fight or flight response. Not easy in the sense of it being technically easy, because it's kind of like drumming. You're adjusting the plow as you're going. You're trying to keep a constant speed. You're trying to think about the grade. You're thinking about how the snow from the skiers on the slope that day moved as they skied. It's a cool gig. And so I heard in the fall, the operations manager is the guy to try to get in on that. So I'm gonna try it, because I hear guys do this for like 25 years and they just love it. Like, you know, I just love operating equipment, that like human mind equipment connection. It's like an engineering system. It's super cool. Skiing is similar too, in the sense that you think there's a bit of a hiccup there, but what I was basically saying is that you're controlling a piece of equipment. Sorry about that there, folks. I don't know what really happened. Oh, Jesus, that was close. Head trauma's not good. I didn't even have my helmet on. That could have been devastating. Stay over there, bad boy. All right, so as I was saying, mind-body connection, controlling equipment, it's something that's amazing. So that groomer lap was fun. Some other guys were getting on it too. We listened to some great tracks. We had some fun. Some of those tracks, the reason I chose them, I'm going through a bit of a rough time, more or less, with some interpersonal things, a relationship, somebody I really care about who just, frankly, I don't think wants me any shred in her life at all anymore, and that's fine. But the problem is when you leave things unsaid and somebody just sort of consciously denies you the closure and the common decency of a human being to ease one's heart, it just, I don't know. But I ski so much and I listen to some tunes, and for whatever reason, a few of these in particular really make me think of this girl. And so I'll dedicate my track selection for this. Even the Ever Seen the Rain, that was a good one. I just randomly started singing that, man. That's a good jam. And so hopefully that one doesn't get me pulled, because I'm sure there's some royalties associated with that. We'll figure it out. So to close today, I'm actually headed up now. I was supposed to meet a friend of mine yesterday to ski, and she bailed because I came out too late and she had to work at 4. So I'm gonna meet her today, and I met her only once before, so hopefully she's not some scam artist and she is a real person. So we'll see what happens, and hopefully she's a good enough snowboarder that I don't mind cruising slow. I call it normies, like AA terminology. I know some people in AA and they call it normies, which is like, you know, the regular people who just ski normal, that aren't blasting around at Mach 3 like us crazy people here. But anyways, so that's what's on the schedule for today. To close the podcast for today, what I'm going to do is put up a video that I took a couple of weeks back, maybe about a week ago. Every once in a while, they groom Peak to Creek on Whistler, and then it's a great morning lap. So I got up super early one day, caught the sunrise here. You can see me chilling here, just almost like I'm at the beach. And this was like 7 in the morning in my home, and it was beautiful. And then this little video here is just from me shredding my GS skis, which I didn't get a chance to talk about earlier in the film here, the podcast. That's my 4th set of skis. It's a genuine straight up race ski, fucking race cut GS ski, and the thing flies. It's like a sports car. As I said before, these bad boys are like a truck. They're like your good daily driver. You can do anything with them, depend on them. The GS skis are like that fucking Ferrari that's just stupid to have, but when you're flying around on it and so in control, you just feel so alive, and you're like, man, engineering. This is awesome. So that's why I like those skis. I just got them this season and I've used them quite a bit. Also impeccable when it gets super icy and nothing else works. So but these guys don't like the ice. I keep the edges purposely like a little dull because I like to slarve around on them. But they're a fun ski. I love these skis. My all-time favorite ski. I've had them for like 12 years now. Yeah, I had a pair of Head Matrix. That was like my high school kid ski. Now I just keep them mounted true center as a park ski, but they're going to get replaced by the whatever they are, Afterbangs. When I finish those up here in a month, I'll post some photos of that when I'm done the project. And you guys can keep an eye out for me on the Blackcomb Glacier this summer, because I'll be there in my fucking shorts, and I'm going to be shredding with those skis that look like a fine, fine European coffee table. So that's the goal, at least. You know, my apartment smells of rich mahogany, and I keep a lot of leather-bound books. I occasionally smoke cigars. Not really, but I occasionally use electronic cigarettes or vaping products, whatever you want to call them. But smoking would be great, but cancer isn't really that cool. But anyhow, where are we now? What tower are we at here? It's a beautiful day. It was a little brighter earlier. Oh yeah, one of my goals before I'm 30 is to summit and ski Wedge. Now, you can't really see Wedge from this angle too well. Well, folks, speaking of engineering technical difficulties, I don't know how long ago my phone kicked off. But anyways, I was just trying to wrap this up. I went on a big rant about GS skis and why I love them and how they're similar to a sports car. They're just stupid fast. They're like a Ferrari. They're a lot of fun, and I'm happy I got them this season. Impeccable on the, or, you know, necessary for the ice, freeze and thaw. These are my daily drivers. I love them. I've had them 12 years, and before then, I had a set of Matrix Heads, the original-ish twin-tip design by Johnny Mosley, or in conjunction with him. Yeah, my camera's still rolling. I think I got this. So anyways, I'm getting close to the top here. I said a little bit about Wedge Mount and how much I love it. Maybe now we can see a little better. There's one face. I'm going to put some, it's my Bob Ross mountain here. I'm going to put a few photos of it up that I took earlier in the season here, just because I'm obsessed. By the time I'm 30 years old, I want to climb and summit it.
Hello, I'm Bob Ross, and I'd like to welcome you. First of all, let me take just a moment to thank you for allowing me back into your homes. If this is your first time with us, let me extend a personal invitation for you to drag out your oil paints and paint along with us each week. Let's go over to the canvas here and let's get started.
I believe, every day's a good day when you paint. I believe, it'll bring a lot of good thoughts to your heart.
And as I said, armchair is really cool too. It's a cool feature. It just looks kind of like the underside of somebody's mouth when you bite, like the inside of your bottom teeth with the vampire teeth and stuff. It's kind of cool. But, okay, so we're still rolling. Getting to the top here, I'm trying to meet up with this girl that I didn't get a chance to ski with yesterday because she had to go to work at 4 and I came out too late. So we'll see how she rides. That'd be kind of cool to, I always like making ski buddy friends, you know, it's like bros and, you know, ladies, whoever wants to ski, we don't even have to ski fast. It's always a good time. Yeah, so another good day in Whistler Blackcomb, the 28th of March, spring conditions, perfect spring conditions, really. Approaching the roundhouse here, I think it's like 1:30 or so in the afternoon, something like that, 1 o'clock. So we're gonna ski some laps and have a good time. And as I said, as I promised, I'm gonna close today's podcast with a little video that I took before I even thought about making this podcast. This just came to me yesterday on the 27th. When I was out here skiing on this lift, and I was like, I should really capitalize on my time a little better than just sitting here listening to audiobooks and podcasts every fucking day. So I decided to make some content of my own, and I think it's a really cool artistic expression. For me, like, I slept yesterday, and I watched these back, and I started doing a little editing and picking the soundtrack, and I'm like trying to think of, okay, when I'm skiing, this is the style I ski when I listen to a certain song. And so I'm like, okay, that song that I listened to when I skied that line should be the song on the podcast. I just see this really coming together. the lyrics, the punchiness of it. It's like artistic, almost spoken word-ish, slash videography, slash podcasting. And if I'm fucking around with people, if I meet some people, I'm a goofy guy, I like to joke around. So this is going to be fun. So I will close today with my GS Turns video from Peak to Creek, because as I said, they groom it every once in a while, and if you get up first tracks, that's a good way to roll. So here's a video of that with my sports car skis. As I said, my other ones are the rich mahogany. I have many leather-bound books, and my apartment smells of rich mahogany. British coffee table style line after bang mod that I'm going to do within the next month, so I'll keep you posted on that too. And you guys can keep an eye out for me around the summer on the glacier. I understand there's Camp of Champions and Momentum and all those things going on, so I'm pretty stoked to just be in the environment. Hopefully they're hiring, we'll see what happens. If not, I'll just go up there to ski. So I like, without further ado, it's a real Rogan line, and you're probably going to notice some cadence in my speech is similar to him, just because I listen to him so damn much. It's almost like a stepfather in a way. Great guy, smart dude, very well balanced, intellectual guy. And I'm addicted to jiu-jitsu now too on his account. Been doing it 4 years, and it's, like I said, it's like skiing with another human, and your souls connect in the same way you connect with nature when you ski. It's super cool. Highly recommended. And if you train jiu-jitsu, I would highly recommend getting into skiing as a form of cross training, because as I find, you're using similar muscle groups, and it's like you're almost having a knee shield up all the time. You're pushing, it's like a delahiva almost. Like, what you're doing when you're skiing is essentially, and you're passing a guard, you know, you're basically like trying to get through the moguls, you're trying to figure out how you're going to ski this line to like pass, and you don't want to get swept. And then it's like long process. It's not super high intensity work, but you're doing it for a long time, like a diesel engine. And that's why I love jiu-jitsu. It's mind over matter. It's position before submission. And it is, what's my other little tagline? There's one I really love about jiu-jitsu. It'll come to me in some other podcast. Jiu-jitsu, skiing, great way to spend your time. Throw a little yoga in there. And you are good, my friend. kettlebells is the other thing. I'm not going to go on a rant here because that's what other podcasts are for, about the benefits of kettlebells and the paleo diet. But take a look for yourself if you're interested. I'm not going to preach because I kind of got into it before it was cool. And now everybody talks about it, and I'm not going to be that guy. Anyhow, I'm going to ski some laps today here. It's another great day. The clouds kind of rolled in, which kind of sucks. Not even, though, because there's still blue sky. Look at that. Look at the lake. The ice is starting to melt. I don't know if you can see that down there. All right, so enjoy my GS video. What I'll probably end up doing now is just basically making clips throughout my week of skiing, or maybe 2-3 days of skiing, and then I'll edit it late in the week, and then I'll post them every Sunday or something, so it'll be kind of a weekly episode, a summary of the week and who I met and what happened that week. And yeah, the summer's going to be sick too, because maybe I'll start doing some photo shoots or videos of like people riding on the park and seeing some real nice diverse mixed up tricks. Like, another thing too, if somebody wants to reach out to me, because I ski a traditional cambered ski and then a rockered ski for my POW ski, but I like the look of a nice stylish Slarvy park rocker ski.
Try them out. I think you'll like them. I love them. If you don't, call me back.
Hard to tell. Zaz is the kicker just going. Zaz is the kicker just going.
Phil Casabon here to talk about the Alpha skis from Armada. Well, the Alpha is a ski I like to ride in the park. They're really a flowy, playful ski, very agile and quick. I love using it as well, like in a very steep and quick environment. This one will manage those turns easily and it's real quick.
Zaz is the kicker to score. Zaz is the kicker to score.
Hard to tell.
Zaz is the kicker to score. Zaz is the kicker to score.
Never skied one before. If you can give me any feedback on that, let me know, because I'm prepping these afterbangs, but they are a full camber ski like this. Am I better off to, like, I'm kind of learning park more or less, so give me some tips if I should start on a full camber ski because I'm really good with that and that's what I know, or if I should go to a rocker ski, because I also ski my rocker ski for POW, and there's a certain way you ski it. It's more like a boat or a jet ski, whereas you ski these more like a car or a truck. So anyways, I am approaching the roundhouse. It's a beautiful day on Whistler Blackcomb. Over and out, everybody. Cheers. Have a great life, and I will see you next time on the show. Thank you.
I mean, there's already tons of factors to worry about when you're hitting a rail. You need everything to fall into place, and you can't be worrying about little things like, oh, if my sidewall blows out, I can't this rail. Skaters basically put their decks through crazy abuse, constantly just hitting concrete, metal, whatever. And this is basically the ski version.
What we've done is we've taken the same maple veneer and we're laminating it up into the actual shape of your ski. We've removed a lot of the plastic. We removed the sidewalls, the top sheet. With the veneer construction, we're able to just stack wood where we want profile. Essentially what you do is you cut down on your wood waste. On top of the base and edges, we put a full length piece of Traxxas fiberglass, another full length piece of maple veneer, tip and tail rubber, another full length piece of wood veneer, then four progressively shorter lengths, creating the flex pattern we were after. On top of that, a layer of Traxxas fiberglass, carbon ollie band, and a full length wood veneer top.
Take more abuse than any ski I've ever ridden. No other ski company's making a ski that's like a skateboard.
They last. I'm out there every day, like I said, and I'm hitting rails every day.
Any sort of weird surface that your mom would be like, doesn't that ruin your skis? Like, this is the ski to take there.
Friends and I, we'd take this basically on brick, off roofs, on rails, across cement, mud.
Wall rides, urban, concrete, wood.
It's gonna either completely smash on the ground or you're gonna ride away clean. It doesn't matter because you're gonna get back up with your friends and keep sessioning just like a skate crew does. I've always wanted a softer ski, something a lot more playful, so you can reach outside the box than just your standard tricks.
The butter zone definitely helps me being able to do presses a lot better than a normal ski, be able to just lean a little bit.
And even when you're taking it to jumps, it is a softer ski, but you can still land.
The symmetry in the ski really helps out for type of tricks I'm trying to do. Like, I don't want the side cut of the ski to be fighting me when I'm riding switch.
They're light, so if I'm trying to do switch ups or 270s on, I'm not worried about catching my skis or anything. You can do stuff like that.
So they've put the carbon ollie band in the afterbang, and it really allows you to ollie over stuff. So if you don't have a jump for an urban rail, or you don't have a jump over a fence or something, you can get so much pop out of the ski.
I'd suggest this to any friend that wants to have a big smile on their face all day and who wants to create their own style.
It's not just made for carving. It's made for anything you can dream up.
All right, go ride all I get you, like.
Yeah, it's good. It's good. You can do it. Oh, that was a good run. Maybe not. No, it's fine. It's soft. Just go like heel edge.
Go heel edge.
Like jump and then heel edge. What a day. Oh, yeah. You got it. Oh shit. Oh shit.
So good?
Oh, this is great. High five, yeah, hold on.
What's up, folks? So it's still the 28th. I did get a chance to meet up with my friend, and she's a solid snowboarder. I am so impressed. I had so much fun skiing two laps with this girl, and it's a shame that she had to work tonight. Man, what a great snowboarder, because she street boards, which is kind of like longboarding that you strap into with bindings like a snowboard. She does that in Japan, and so her carving is impeccable. I had so much fun skiing with her. Anyways, that worked out. It's a shame that I missed her yesterday, but that was a good victory lap. Anyways, I am sweating my bag off here. It's warm out today, and we just completely shredded. That was a fun run. I'm going back up the gondola now. It's 2:30. This was kind of an impromptu thing. I'll include this in the podcast too for this episode, but I'm also gonna promise, or as I promised, finish off with my GS skiing video from Peak to Creek. So I'm going to roll that right now before I get distracted with something else. And if it's still such a nice day and it's only 2:30, so the clouds are rolling in a tad, but it is still a beautiful day in Whistler Blackcomb. Do how you say Whistler Blackcomb? Yes, beautiful place. Anyways, so we've concluded that I'm not going to say her name on the air. Somebody I skied with today was an excellent snowboarder and I had a great time. I hope I get to ride with her again. I'm going to put my GS video on. You guys can have some fun watching that. That's from about a week ago. And maybe one more Slarvy video, and then I'm going to call it a day or a week. And I'll do this every week. This is a lot of fun so far. It's only been 2 days. And what I might actually do is try to reach out to Whistlife, because they're a cool little establishment. I forgot the guy's name, but they told me all about him. He's like a longtime local here. He comes every once in a while and he travels a lot too. But he, I believe, owns, don't quote me on that, the cigar shop. Sorry, folks. My phone ran out of storage space. So I'm gonna have to like figure something out here with this whole mobile recording thing. I like having the phone in the hand while I'm skiing. That's pretty cool. Maybe a selfie stick would work. I got to get a little better at this. I honestly am not a filmographer, whatever the fuck you want to call it, a videographer. Like, I'm just doing this for fun, so be easy on me. So I'm going to try not to ramble on too much. We are somewhat approaching the roundhouse here. It's, like I said, probably about 2:40 now on the 28th of March. Another great day at Whistler Black Home. I love when you start to get that gradient of shadows and sunlight. It kind of reminds me again of Bob Ross paintings.
A lady came up to him and she says, "Oh my gosh," she says, "you're so fantastic." She says, I would give half my life to be able to play like you do." And he looked at her and he said, "I did." So that's all. It's just practice. You can be the best. All you have to do is practice. Devote some time to it. Well, I get to talking here and trees just appear everywhere. If I talked for a couple more minutes, we'd have a whole canvas full of trees. Tell you what, let's put
a joy of painting. Look them up. God bless them and rest in peace. GS video coming up, maybe a slurvy video of my afternoon's day. Then I'm going to wrap this bad boy up and get this episode posted. And I will do one of these every week. As I was saying before I was cut off there, I might connect with Whist Life and see if they want to do a reciprocal agreement with promotions. Because I met them through, they were posting an ad for being a massage technician and providing some free training in agreeing to work there. I was considering doing that because I thought massage might be really cool to get into. I sometimes like to give myself massages and... But anyways, just again, that mind-body connection kind of thing. But I didn't end up doing that, but I do know about them. The cigar shop's cool too. If you vape, they've got some good e-cig line up there too. I think Whistler Vapes, they call it. And I guess that's about it. What was the CA? Barber. So they also have a really good barber. And the funny thing is, when I went in there in the summer, my barber from Richmond that grew up cutting my hair, I grew up having him cut my hair, his nephew works here at Castro's Cigar Shop, Barber Shop. It's hilarious. So anyways, ABC is Aviva Massage, Barbershop, and Castro, see Castro Cigar Shop. Cool establishment, Whist Life. If you watch this, shout out to me and let's work something out here. Let's throw your brand on this, or we'll figure something out. And if you're not interested, that's cool too. Keep on keeping on. So without further ado, we're gonna ski another lap. I'll probably post that one up, but I will definitely put the GS one on right now from last week. And then I'll wrap the podcast up for the week and we will post this on Sunday, which is going to be April probably. That's good. If we could start on April Fools, this would be great. The podcast premieres on April Fools 2019. I'll try to make that happen. And then there'll be one every Sunday. Let's go with that. All right, folks, everybody keep safe out there. Keep on skiing, follow the Alpine Responsibility Code, and over and out. Cheers. So we're at the top of Roundhouse here, and everyone's having a good time. This is Black Point today. You having a good time, yeah? You like skiing? Yeah, yeah. Have a good lap.
Have fun.
So what we're gonna do now is ski a nice afternoon lap, and I was so inspired by this girl's just ridiculous style in the park. Just knocked my socks off. So I'm gonna go do a park lap. I don't ski much park, but we're gonna have a little fun here. I'm sorry. I was totally in the wrong. That was my mistake. I didn't see you. I'm so sorry. Folks, so I'm back home now. That was an epic 2 days, I must say. It was a good time. I hope you guys enjoyed that video of my GS turns on Peak to Creek. I hope you enjoyed that little park lap. That was fun too. And I'm really excited to make another one of these. So I'm gonna get to editing now. I'm in my armchair, and we'll see what happens here. I'm pretty tired. That was a good day, and two nights of going out, I'm pretty bagged. I gotta get some sleep here. So tonight's going to be an early one. It is, Wednesday, Thursday, something. And so I'll try to get this edited by Sunday, and then we'll have this posted for April Fools. All right, everyone, over and out. Cheers.